Saturn 1 requesting startup.
Gunman 2-1, clear to start engines.
One wheels up.
Chief, remove the wheel chocks.
Copy. Wheel chocks are now removed.
Tower, Gunman 2-1, ready to taxi.
Gunman 2-1, clear to taxi. Hold short, runway 11 left.
Copy, Tower, hold short, runway 11 left. Gunman 2-1 requesting takeoff.
Gunman 2-1 clear for takeoff runway 11 left.
121 Airborne.
Yeah, I saw the briefings. So we've got Shiraz pretty much secured. It's
just the countryside to the northwest that's branding country.
Pretty much. Shiraz is still a concern, but it's locked down quite hard. We got checkpoints and all the major routes into the city. But the rest of the Zagros Mountains northwest of Shiraz is still pretty wild. IRGC have got the ground in a big way, playing hit and run throughout the region. We've got a full-blown insurgency going on up here. We're seeing regular ambushes and IED attacks on our patrols. Not to mention reprisal attacks and early days of dares to support us on the new government.
The brief said there's still some proper equipment in their hands as well.
Nothing too advanced, but the insurgents managed to retreat with plenty of older gear intact. We see burdens and bumps in the field, along with plenty of AAA, manpad, and even a few open mobile fab, geckos and gaskets. Even a game full of insurgents are all over the region, but their nerve center is a city of Yasuj, close to Mount Dina. We think this is where the steam. Insurgent commanders are. Unfortunately, so far it's proven a tough nut to crack. The city is crawling with fighters, AAA and SAMs. Right now it's a no-go area. The current plan is to isolate it from the surrounding area and slowly flush the insurgents out of the towns and villages instead.
You think that'll work?
Fuck knows.
So you think the IRGC leadership is hiding in Yasuj?
Safest place for them. That's where I'd be.
How important are they? If we take them out, do we expect the insurgents to suddenly drop their weapons?
I don't see that happening somehow. But the brass is pretty fired up to get them. Maybe they know something we don't.
Maybe they know about WMDs.
Well, we think we got most of them, thank God.
Let's hope so.
Overlord.
One sec.
Overlord, Gunman 1-1 reporting in as bragged. Any words?
Gunman 1-1, negative on words. Proceed on fragged route. Overlord out.
down to starboard. It was an insane strong open. Handled the police pretty relentlessly and went in bumper. Sure left a mess. God knows what the civilian cost was. Let's hope it was worth it. So what chance do you think this new government has of succeeding?
Well, that's a good question, Steve. I'm not sure I can answer it. Things are really complicated out there right now. As well as the major insurgency happening here, we see more groups springing up in the last few months. The Iranian Liberation Front, the Islamic Army of Iran, not to mention that the Sunni group that you attacked by mistake is still active.
New Dawn's promise? I thought they would have settled down by now.
No, they're proving to be a real problem. It seems they're not happy. The people of Iran still want a Shia-led government.
Bloody democracies. So what are they doing? Fighting against the new government?
Yep, as well as fighting everyone else, including, we think, us when it suits. It turns out they are a bit more extreme of a group than we realized. Or that someone turned a blind eye to it.
Why? What did you hear?
There have been linked to quite a few massacres in villages loyal to the old Iranian regime. Burned a few places to the ground, mass executions, you know how it goes. A couple of attacks on our troops are suspected to be carried out by them as well. We just can't prove it.
When we were in league with these people, Jesus, we even had troops fighting with them.
Naive Steve, we've been here before. The Sunni insurgents we supported turned extremists. You ever heard of Bin Laden, right?
Yeah, I hear you, boss.
None of it surprises me anymore. You know when the Shah ran Iran, back when we were friends, they think the security services actually used to cook people as a type of torture. They fucking grilled people. But as long as they were against communists, I guess it was alright. And Saddam and all this talk of WMDs, we weren't so bothered when he was gassing Iranians, were we? The whole situation out here is so fucked. Sorry, Steve. I'm just pissed off. None of that changes the mission, though. We're here to protect our guys on the ground. They didn't ask for this any more than we did.
Yes, sir. David, have you seen the intel reports from Syria? Looks like things are getting messy over there.
Yeah, this Arab Spring has really left its mark. Syria looks like it's only going to add to the region's problems.
Last I read, government forces had rolled into Homs, trying to crush the resistance over there.
That's right. Apparently the fighting is pretty fierce, but all the civilians are getting caught up in it as well. Things look to me like they're going to get out of hand. That's another country with a history of brutal crackdowns. Who knows what the rebels are thinking? They might just file on hoping for another Western intervention.
Who knows how that'll play out?
Well, think about this scenario, Steve. Iran borders Iraq, borders Syria. Three destabilized countries, active insurgencies in each, extremist elements operating in each. One screwed up region. And us, we're at it.
I won't pack my bags just yet then, sir.
we stay on the flight, man, we'll be out of range.
So I heard you eventually ended up over to Rab.
That's right. The 74th ended up following ground forces all the way to the north. We seemed to be in constant command. Wasn't much of a fight in the end. By the time our forces were approaching the city, most of the senior leadership had fled. There was some token resistance, but most of the city fell quickly to the uprising.
I'd have thought there would have been more trouble from the IRGC.
Well, they caught it out there. Looks like they'd already gone ground by that point. Quietly started pulling out and relocating over here in the mountains.
How secure is the rest of the country?
Depends where you go. There's still a lot of pockets of fighting going on. Different factions, groups fighting each other. And however, this region is still the most contested by far.
And I heard you're training the new Iranian military as well.
Yeah, that's right. By all accounts, they're learning fast. We only have to, I think. The sooner we can hand it over, the better in my eyes. About 10 miles to port is Yasu, the insurgency stronghold. Remember, we're staying well clear for the time being. Behind Yasu is Mount Dina, the highest mountain in the Zagros Range. It peaks at over 30,000 feet high. Gunman 1-1 approaching waypoint 5. Any words?
Gunman 1-1, negative reports at this time. Overload out.
Set Fox Mike purple.
Two, one, set.
Miller 3-2, this is Gunman 1-1. Two times 8-10 inbound to support. Give me a
Wingman 1-1, this is Miller 3-2. Set cries for you guys. Situation down here is real bad. A convoy was hit by a suicide bomb truck. Everyone in the lead vehicle was killed. The rest of us got out and managed to fall back to a compound 100 feet to the west. We've since come under heavy attack from approximately 20 insurgents. We beat off the first attack, but we took losses. There's only four of us left now.
Got the insurgents falling back.
For now, but I think they're regrouping for another attack. Get over here, quick!
Okay, son, relax. We're almost with you. What's your name, soldier?
Lance Corporal Harris. Kevin.
Okay, Harris. First of all, are any of you guys down there qualified as FAC?
No, sir. We lost our FAC in a firefight.
Okay, Harris. Now I need to confirm your position. From what you told me from the wrecked vehicles, if I look 100 feet west, I can see a two-story building, a wall compound, and a gate on the east corner. Is that your position?
Yeah, that's us.
Okay, Harris. Now we need to know which direction the attack came from.
Sir, from the east. About 400 feet east of our position is a tree line. That's where the first attack came from. We've got smoke grenades and launchers with us. We'll mark the position with red smoke when they attack again.
Copy that, Miller 3-2.
Sounds like a well-planned ambush, Davey.
You got that right, Steve. Look, there's a man pad back there as well. Maybe we show up. Okay, Harris, sit tight, we're almost there. Do you have an ETA on the QRF?
Yes, sir. We've got the QRF platoon about 15 minutes away.
Copy that, Miller 3-2. Okay, Steve, here's the plan. I'm gonna be FAC A, you're gonna make the attacks. Hold a few miles south while I make you a 9-line. Side 1 control. IP, I want you to run in along the long straight road southwest of Mill's position. 035. 3 miles. 4 5 2 5 9 feet MSL. 5 infantry. 6 tree line 100 feet east of burning vehicles. 7 red smoke. 8, friendlies 400 feet west. 9, egress north.
5-9, 5-9 feet, tree line east of burning vehicles, friendlies 400 feet west.
Read back correct. I'll position over the IP, wait for my instruction to attack.
Thank you.
We're taking fire again, marking the tree line.
Gunman 2-1, we have red smoke. Commence your attack. Recommend guns. Caution, man pad 300 feet to the east.
Gunman 2-1, do not engage without clearance.
This is Miller 3-2. Insurgents are pulling back.
Gunman 2-1, cease fire.
Gunman 2-1.
Miller 3-2, where's Harris? Are you okay?
This is Private Ford. Harris is dead, sir.
Copy, Private. Everyone else okay down there?
Yes, sir. We're okay.
Gunman 2-1, hold up the IP.
Gunman 1-1, we're taking RPG fire. Shit, that was close.
Get into cover, Ford. I've got Talia in their position. We'll handle it.
Yes, sir.
Gunman 2-1, new target. Two-story building, 600 feet northeast of burning vehicles. RPGs on the roof.
Thank you. Pull up, pull up.
Tully target.
Same 9-line, Steve. Recommend GBU.
Come on, 2-1. Gunman 2-1 is in.
Aboard. Go around.
Warning, autopilot.
Looks like we got a runner. Someone's making a break for it. Building directly northeast of the RPG position. One armed male on foot. Okay, target
warning,
the end of
autopilot.
The Land Rover. Side towards the road. Let him clear the village. We'll take him in the open. Okay, Gunman 2-1. Target is clear of the village and heading west off road. Type 3 control. You're cleared to engage.
Gunman 2-1.
Shooting, Steve. Target destroyed. Steve, Italian Iranian vehicles to the north. Looks like reinforcements are on the way. I've got 2 Burdams and 1 Strela.
SC9? Shit. Can you turn me on?
From the burning vehicles, follow the road north to the junction, and then follow the road west. You'll see them traveling along this road. Stop them reaching Miller's position. Type 3 control, clear to engage.
Command 2-1.
Miller 3-2, this is Charlie 4-1. We're at 5. Minutes out with Kiora.
Copy, Charlie 4-1.
Charlie 4-1, this is Gunman 1-1.
Go ahead, Gunman 1-1.
Charlie 4-1, I need you to hold to the south until I clear you. We've got sound rolling in.
Copy, Gunman 1-1.
Warning, autopilot. Pull up, pull up.
Goodman 1-1, all targets destroyed.
Good work, Steve, good work. Return to the IP and hold for further instructions. Charlie 4-1, LZ is clear of sound threat. You are cleared to proceed.
Charlie 4-1. Charlie 4-1 is wheels down. Additional friendlies on the ground.
Watch your fire, Steve. QRF pushing out a perimeter.
Gunman 1-1, QRF is reporting position secure.
Gunman 1-1 copies. Ford, still with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, son. Looks like the situation is under control now. We're RTB. Good luck, soldier.
Thank you, sir. We really owe you one. Miller 3-2 out.
Overlord, Gunman 1-1.
This is Overlord.
Overlord, QRF is on the ground and position is secure. Request clearance to RTB.
Clearance granted, Gunman 1-1. Overlord out.
Steve, let's head for home. Form back on me. Comment 2-1, request clearance from Shiraz Tower and land. I'll see you back on the ground. Tower, Goodman 2-1, requesting permission to land.
Gunman 2-1, you are cleared for landing, runway 29 right.
Altitude.
Wheelchucks.
Copy. Wheelchucks are now removed.
Chief, place the Wheelchucks.
Copy. Wheelchucks are now in place.